Because one small thing is, I also remember, we were in San Francisco, and we were having meetings discussing what was our identity, what is our mission, where is it all? So one of our very hard for the last year, talking in Hindi, says, what is our identity, who are we? And then we said to him, who's your true Maharaj? He was like, you, Guru. Then he says, what bigger identity or what exactly do you have? Then this is my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj is not your true Maharaj. That I come from this Sampradaya, that this is my lineage, this is our identity of who we are. And then I asked, then what is our mission, what is our goal? And he said, our goal is twofold. One is to make ourselves Krishna conscious, which really means to do pleasant things, to taste and realize all of these things in our hearts. And the other is to make the whole world Krishna conscious and spread this. So those who are DBS or Pure Bhakti Yoga Society are the ones who are disciples, followers of the Guru and the Ramana, to make themselves Krishna conscious and the whole world Krishna conscious. So I'll leave it here.
कोई महापुरुष की कृपा से
Pero no es esta parte de alegría, es el futuro de Dios. Yo lo que es puro contigo es porque te das cuenta de tu verbo, de hablar de ti, añado a ti. Hay veces que parte, tanto que te dicen lo mentira, de que no creen que hay baile de tu área de acá. Es una actitud de lo que me mata, porque va a estar en acá. Partir por el final, tanto que la santa se te da, que está en la obra, 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 está दूसरी बात है मतलब तीन वर्ग कम मात्र गौरीय वैष्णव संप्रदाय केवल गौरीय वैष्णव संप्रदाय ने इसके साथ कम मात्र आय को स्वीकार करना ही पड़ेगा। आय ऐसा नहीं है कि मध्वाचार्य के बाद महापुरुष धारा को और विशुद्ध रूप में फिल्टर करके हम लोगों के पास करें। उससे पहले हम भक्तिता के बाद पहले उनका जो सिद्धांत है चारों जातों का महापुरुष ने कहीं कहीं सबके साथ समन्वय करके बात बताई है जो तुम कहो लेकिन उनको कह कर तो ब्रह्म भगवान को सबके सीमा में बांध नहीं सकते क्योंकि अचित शक्ति महत्वपूर्ण है चाहे निष्ठा ग्रंथवाद को है वैदा ग्रंथवाद को है सुधार ग्रंथवाद को वेदा के जो भी कहो लेकिन कहीं न कहीं तत्कर्म द्वारा एक शक्ति के द्वारा अचित इसलिए कोई चीज धान पूर्ण है इतना ही ऐसा नहीं कर सकते अगर हम सब सिद्धांतों में पूर्णता होती तो वहां पूरी के लिए सब जगह प्रयोग नहीं करते अपना मत अचित शक्ति राष्ट्र जीव गोस्वामी जी अचानक के विचारों का जब रचना का रिकॉर्ड संदर्भ में सिद्धांत का कितना तो संदर्भ में प्रथम संदर्भ है जहां पर उनको अर्थों को प्रकाशित किए महापुरुष के भावों को प्रकाशित किए महापुरुष क्या बताए क्या हमें सिखाए हमारे गुरु कृपानु गुरु वैभव क्या दिए संदर्भ में बताए पूरे अर्थों से प्रकाशित से सारों की दृष्टि विचार करते 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 आत्मा तो मते अजय सकती है मेरे मत से हमारे महापुरुष के मत से जो आप तुम कह रहे हो कहीं न कहीं अचीत है आपका इतना भेद है इतना भेद है जैसे मध्वाचार्य जी बोले जीव जीव में भेद जीव जड़ में भेद जड़ जड़ में भेद जीव भगवान में भेद जो पांच प्रकार के भेद को दर्शाए जो भेदभाव को बोले महापुरुष के प्रति एक पक्ष स्वीकार करने से नहीं चलेगा दूसरा पक्ष स्वीकार करने से नहीं चलेगा दोनों के पीछे बहुत पक्ष है वह अचिंत है कितना भेद है कितना भेद है जिसको कोई माफ करके नहीं कर सकता है तो भगवान की कृपा से जिसको जितना प्राप्ति होता है उतना भी व्यक्त कर सकता है पूर्ण रूप से नहीं कर सकता भगवान की महिमा को भगवान की लीला को तत्वों पर पूर्ण नहीं कर सकते कितना है कितना है अचिंत है हाँ गुरु वैष्णव कृपा से जितना आपको हृदय में दे उतना आप समझ सकते वही वही ब्रह्मा जी से सुन रहे थे सर्वप्रथम हमारे आया के जो गुरु है ब्रह्मा जी ब्रह्मा के कृष्ण है ये चतुर्मुख अन्य ब्रह्मा जी के सारे तत्व सिद्धांत कृष्ण ने दिए सारे भक्ति जो सूर भक्ति की धारा जैसे भागवत में आया ज्ञानम परम विजयम ने जय विज्ञान समन्वितम सर रहस्यम तत्व के ग्रहण करी सबने जावन हम दशा भाव जय रूप मून करम कर तथैव तत्व विज्ञानम अस्तु ते मधुर एक बात पता है मैं तुमको वो ज्ञान देने जा रहा हूँ विज्ञान से जुड़ते हैं बहुत से लोग इस पर मार खा जाते हैं ज्ञान कर्म क्या है कि भाई माता ये समझ पाते हैं उनसे ज्ञान कर्म को भक्ति से फैल तो लेकिन भगवान स्वयं से ज्ञान दे रहे हैं तो आप फैले क्या ज्ञान की निंदा नहीं है ज्ञान कर्म अपने जगह पर सही है लेकिन जिस ज्ञान कर्म अद्भुत का भाव नहीं है उसको निंदनीय कहा गया इस वस्तु को जो ब्रह्मा जी ने भगवान ने ब्रह्मा जी को दिया ब्रह्मा जी कृपा करके लाल जी को दिए और बोले देखो भाई मैं तो उसकी आगे काल इतना व्यर्थ रहता हूँ मैं इसके अंदर विस्तार नहीं कर सकता और बहुत समय तुम इसको विस्तार कर सारे तत्वों ने जो बताए जैसा हरो भक्ति भगवती निर्नाम भक्ति भली सति सर्व आत्मा अभिलाष आए की संकल्प बने लेकिन अब पूजा आया पूजा पाठ करके लिए मुझे कृष्ण सब करने के लिए उधर भी बारे में नहीं करें ज्ञान उनको रहता नहीं है क्यों हमारा अच्छा हो रहा है क्योंकि बहुत ज्ञान उसको रोक रहे हैं नहीं अच्छा स्वभाव कर देगा कृष्ण के नाम से लीला संकीर्तन करो उनका कौन सा सरकार का नहीं है तो नहीं करो जो दो हने अपने वसों पर पड़े प्रेम ने नाग दिलो चरमात्मा तो गायनी जय नम रक्त हिरो सुकत हो कन्या वैश्य रुख चित जान गाय मेरे गुरु गोविंद दामोदर माधवे हे कृष्ण हे जा हे सके जी खुद गाय की नाम हरि चलो तो हमारे जो गुरु वगैरह ऐसे जो भक्ति कार तो मधुरा जाने के बाद महाप्रभु जी शुद्ध रूप में तो प्रकाश महाप्रभु ने जो वस्तु को दिया उसी में हमारे गुरु वर्ग जो वस्तु को करके इसको पालन करें भागवत इसी बात को नारद जी बोले ना तथा वस्तु देव का महिमा ना भगवान की महिमा भगवान की भक्ति को सुन लाए तो वर्णन नहीं करे तो धर्म काम उसको जब इस पूर्व शासन दिया कर दिया महाप्रभु जी उसको विष्णु रूप में कर दिया और उसको व्रत के भक्ति में उसके जो लिखा है उस पर गुरु महाराज जी भक्ति का नारायण गुरु महाराज जी गुना कई बार कथाओं में बोलते कि नारद जी प्यार से पूछ रहे हैं कि तुमने ऐसा कहीं लिखा श्री लाने में पढ़ा लिखा तुम नहीं लिखा भगवान पढ़ा है सबसे बड़ा सबसे पे बड़ा जो सबको पढ़ा करता है लेकिन जब बोला तो उसके छाती पर भी चढ़ जाता है नहीं ये लिखा है कुछ पढ़े थे जो ग्वालियर थोड़ा छात्र भी नजर आते हैं सटा लोग उसको अपने सिर से बाहर निकाल देते हैं हाय हरी जीते श्री रामा भरत इनका कर्तव्य वस्तु सही है तुम देव बोला कि तेरे बहन गणेश का उसको जयकार करते लेकिन ताली कहीं रहती छो भर गया छियावर शासन के ना जन्म चावे तेजा महेश गणेश दिने सुबेश मुजाई निरंतर जावे जावे अनादि अनंत अखंड अचेत आवेद सुमेद बतावे नारद से भूमि का से बैठे पति हाथ करो भूमि मारण पावे ताई हरी रही छो हरी राज यावर शासन के ना चलता निर्दति वेदांत सिद्धांत सुन सके और सुगम एकम नंद निकेतन गणेश सिद्धांत बोध निर्दुषिता मोहित निकेतन ते तारे जिससे योग ज्ञान और ज्ञान आदि है इससे आत्मा की उतनी प्रसन्नता है कि इतना भक्ति जैसे आत्मा समर्पित है इतना है तुम नाम बोलो तुम नाम भक्ति करो इसी बात को हमारे गुरुवर्गो ने बड़े सुंदर अवसर उसमें दिए जिसके पाने के बाद सारे ज्ञान और ज्ञान लोग अपने आप ही हो जाते फिर उसमें प्रवृत्ति नहीं होती शुद्ध भक्ति रह जाती है और भाव में डूब करके हम गुरुवर्गो का अनुग्रह दूसरे को बड़े सरल रूप में पाने हाथ से खेलते पाने कठिन नहीं है पर गलत हो जाए तो वो आनंद के साथ ही
Gracias. for some time to speak on Bhakti Tattva and the special contribution of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So first, it's been explained by the different speakers that many personalities have explained pure bhakti. That in Narada Maharaja, Sahu Adi Vinaya Mukham, Tattva Vinaya Lama, Rishikesha Rishikesha Seva Bhakti, that one who by executing process of sad bhakti, which is Sajay Kavet Sajay Bhavasasa Navita, when the heart becomes purified of Sahu Adi Vinaya Mukham, of all bodies, all material designations relating to this material body and this world, Vinaya Mukta, when one speaks, Sahabhati Vinaya Mukta, Tatpara Vinaya Mukta, Vinaya Mukta, and one is directed solely to Tatpara Mukta, to the Supreme Lord, Rishikesha, that the senses are engaged fully and one-pointedly to the Lord of the senses, Rishikesha, then this is pure devotional service. Also, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, then also pure bhakti is described. So I will suffer your Ramon, Yadu Bhakti, I hope today. According to Yadu Bhakti, you have no stupidity. That so I will suffer your Ramon, that what is the supreme nature of the living entity, the ultimate nature, the intrinsic nature, Savai Pusa Parodhano Yakutav here is devotion to Devostev, to Lord Devostev. And but how should it be? Or what should it be? It should be without any material desire. No karma, mixture of karma, jnana, moksha, etc. Or what should it be? Apatita, it should be continuous, like a flow. What should it be? Apatita, the Yakutav's facility. And by this type of devotional service, then Krishna is pleased, and automatically the living entity is totally pleased. That devotional service which is mixed with karma, desire for fruits of gain, jnana, knowledge, mystic perfection, adi, etc., that this will not satisfy Krishna and the soul will not be satisfied. But the living entity, for millions and millions of lives, is due to the influence of the three most material nature and Maya illusion is searching after so many material objects in this world. But if I believe to see Krishna himself, he also speaks of mixed devotional service and then pure devotional service. In the seventh chapter, he explains Chasavila Chasimam Janasim to Rijuna. Ato, Yasu, Atavi, Yana, Shabbat, Shabbat. The four types of people come to me. Here he's talking about basic devotional service, those people with desires. Those people who are inquisitive, who want wealth, and jnana, vishvabhakti, in search of knowledge. But in the ninth chapter, then he speaks about pure devotional service. And in that pure devotional service, he speaks of the supreme devotional service of the presence of Vrindavan. Mandana Bhavatko, Manaji Mandamaskuru. So, Maharaj is asked or requested that we speak on what is your bhakti, and also we explain how this is coming through the four samprayas and how it culminates the contribution of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, Srila Prabhupada says, Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, he has written a book, Four Samprayas. And in this book, he's explained that first, bhakti is coming as a seed. That is coming as a seed from Lord Brahma, Narayana Muni. And then it starts to, this seed, it starts to bud. And it starts to unfurl with the four acharyas. With the four acharyas. Sri Ramakrishna Acharya, Madhava Acharya, Vishnu Swami, and Indonesia. Sri Ramakrishna Acharya represented the Shishta Dvaitava. And his worshipful deity was Lakshmi Narayana. So basically, in a nutshell, because Maharaj said so, one of you are enough to go into detail on this. So, the Shishta Dvaitava, in a nutshell, is that there is one whole have, for instance, an explanation, the silver microphone. So this silver and black microphone, the microphone is the noun, and then the adjectives, silver and black, are defining the microphone. So this, these adjectives represent the material cosmic manifestation, inert matter, and also living entities. And the Supreme Lord, Brahma, this is the microphone. But together, then they make a whole component. This is Vishishta. Vishishta and Vishesha, the nouns and the adjectives. So then after Ramachandra, then came Srimad Bhattacharya. Srimad Bhattacharya presented Vaishnava. We see pictures of Srimad Bhattacharya also has his hand in two pages, and he would not admit any Advaita in his philosophy. So we see that there's Vishishta Advaita, Shuddha Advaita, Advaita Advaita. But Srimad Bhattacharya, Advaita. Already Vishnu Maharaj has explained the five eternal differences which are there, which is presented. And after him came Vishnu Swami. He presented Shuddha Advaita. Sri Sarvakrishna presented Kevala Advaita, where he completely, he rejected duality. Whereas with the Shuddha Advaita of Vishnu Swami, he has completely accepted the duality. So it's purified oneness. Understanding that that oneness, there's duality. And then after him, there's Aditya, and he presented Advaita Advaita. But his Advaita Advaita is called Svabhavik Advaita Advaita. So now, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his coming, then that very beautiful and sweet lotus flower now is unfurling and blossoming. And he's presented the synthesis of all these four different acharyas. Even we can say that Sri Shankaracharya is Kevala Advaita, he is presented in a hidden form of Sri Advaita. Because he's presented the concept of Adevachaniya. Adevachaniya means indescribable. That how is it that there is only one where we see so much variety? He says that there is a oneness and a duality. On the pure plane there's duality, on the absolute plane there's oneness. So he's playing oneness and duality. But he says it's Adevachaniya. It cannot be described. But actually it's described, well actually what it is a sutra. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is called Sri Jiva Goswami. Then he has presented Aditya Vedavya Sattva Siddhanta. He composed first, Ekam Paramat Tattvam Svabhavik Aditya Shankara Saha Deva Shrutta Shrutta Jiva Pradhan Rupena. That Ekam Ekam Paramat, that there is one absolute supreme person of God, that Ekam Ekam Paramat Tattvam, that Svabhavik. Prior, Sri Nipatitya has used the word Svabhavik. Svabhavik means natural, that there's a natural oneness and difference. But there's some defect in this presentation. Just like if you have the body, and there's a natural oneness of the body and the different parts of the body, the hands, the legs, etc. But if you cut off a hand, then the defect goes to the whole body. So this is the defect in this presentation. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is presented Svabhavik Achintya Shakti, that the transformation which is going on are not coming to the body of Brahman, but it's coming through Shakti. So the fourth acharya then presented, what's it? Brahman? Brahman? Vasu Parinamba. They presented Vasu Parinamba, meaning that if there's some transformation, that transformation is coming from Brahman. So whatever defect is going to Brahman. But also in the Vedas it's stated that Brahman has no transformation. So how is it possible? So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this follows, they presented Ekam Evam Paramam Svabhavik Achintya Shakti. That the transformations are coming from the Shaktis. That Lord, He has His Antarama Shakti, Bahirama Shakti, Tathastra Shakti. That from His Antarama Shakti, you have to transcend the world, the associates. These are all transformations coming from that Shakti. From the Tathastra Shakti, you have the living entities. And from the Bahirama Shakti, you have the then having bypass means that with the Supreme Lord, he has the transcendental Dham, his transcendental associates, that these are emanations coming from that Supreme Lord. And then G, the living entities. Padam, this material cause of manifestation in its unmanifest form. So he says, then how can we understand that? Then Srila Jiva Goswami is presented. Shakta Chisate Yam Ramanasita Teja Eva Antata Bahiyakita Rasmi. That you can understand by these four things. That in the sun planet, you have the sun god. He is the presiding deity, the predominating deity. And then you have the sun globe itself. The sun globe is like the transcendent world, the eternal associates of the Lord. And then you have the rays coming from the sun planet, and these are the living entities. And then Bhagavata Rasmi, Tatpatita Yurvena. And then you have the reflection of the sun. This is the material world. So in this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates, they have taken, he's synthesized, and he's presented the complete philosophy of Achyuta Vaidya Tattva, taking all that was defective in the others and making gold. But, as Srimad Madhusudana Maharaj has explained, but not only that, but he's presented bhakti, which is Rasmai bhakti, which is full of rasa. That the other chariot, they presented bhakti, which is dealing with Vaikuntha bhakti, going to Vaikuntha. Even though there's some mention of, in the Nityas Ramadaya, worshiping Rupini, Rupini and Krishna. But the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that they're like the honeybees, that now they're going and they're tasting the honey, which is unfurled from that most well. And how they're facing, Anamikasa Nishra, Karunaya Dhana Kalo, Samapai Kamunosa Gaurasa Swabhakti. That Shirada Nathavni is Lutta Vitam Sopreya Namamita Asikara. Apara Yogi Tatara Gala, Krishna Kanyas Mahamapali. That two versions say to you, Shirada Nathavni, that after a very long time, that bhakti which is not forgiven, what is that bhakti? Raja bhakti. Shirada Nathavni, Nishra Lutta Vitam. Which is very, very good. It is the most precious thing in the storehouse. But how is it achieved? Go look at it. Prema Nam Hari Nam Sankata. Sirada Yatam Nijaludha Vikam Svaprem Namam Vita. That is achieved through chanting Nam. And by this sadhya, that one will achieve that sadhya of Prem Nam. Svaprem Namam Vita Atikudara. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers, they're drinking this honey. Then they become so drunk that in this intoxicated state, then they think, where are they living? Asikudara, that very, very deliberately, they're thinking here and there. They're not making any kind of consideration of who is high caste, who is low caste. But a power of being that even those who are very fallen, drunkards, this and that, all the spiritual things can be said, but those who come and take shelter of the Sampradaya Vinaye, Matrasa Slavata, take it with sincerity, then they're giving. They're drinking the honey, intoxicated, and drops of that honey coming, and the sprinkling, and those who are very fortunate coming to Sampradaya Vinaye Mahaprabhu, under the guidance of Srila Rupa Goswami and associates, then they're able to drink and become also intoxicated by the God.
Спасибо.
भाव का है पांच भाव से पांच रस में भी उपासना करते हैं।